soul leads me. And the love I fought to feel was always me. But if all the things are done, yeah, just attempts at letting go, yeah, cause the hole inside my heart is still in me. I tried to go, was always here. And the path I tried to go, oh, okay, was always clear. Why has life become a plan? Put some money in my hand. When the love I really need is still in you. What if the love I hold to be was always me? And the love I fought to feel was always free. What if all the things I've done
Good morning, ugly and lovely students. Here we are for our first class with by YouTube. In these days, I know they are tough days, they are difficult days, but we can go through them. We will survive. Okay, everything we will start with a song. Today's song is a stupid tip. I'm gonna erase it, okay? I'll give that 2-3 minutes of that song for you to get in and to start. I'm sorry. Today I started a little late, but there were some troubles here. Okay, so what are we going to do today? We are going to start with science class, but first of all, you cannot talk in Spanish, okay? If you talk in Spanish, I will write your name here. So let's just start doing it. Okay, Spanish, okay. Let's see, if you have to write, you just have to write in English. Okay, so let's just start with it. I know, maybe the quality of the video is not the best one. Okay, we will have like a half an hour of class, something like that, and then we will stop it, and then we'll start with science, with English. Okay, let's see if we open the blinds. If I put the blinds up, maybe we get more light. We'll see. Okay, so what are we going to do today? I'm going to open. First of all, I don't talk in Spanish. Okay, very good, Patricia. Judith Moran, talk in English, please. Okay, so here we are. We are 29. I think that's enough to start. First thing I'm going to do, I'm going to open. We are going to start with science. Okay, we are going to go through. So, to read, we are going to go through the different photocopies, and we are going to do some activities here on the whiteboard. So, first of all, I moved my two folders that were here, okay, I moved them to David Tareas Corona V, okay? If you get in, You've got English and science and the new instructions. Okay, let's start with science. So if we get in, we've got some photocopies. First one. This one I gave it to you last week, I think it was. Okay, we review a little bit of different forms of energy and we did some activities. So please take out this photocopy. That's the first thing you have to do. Okay, I give you 30 seconds for taking out that photocopy. Because I told you to do activity 4 for homework, but we didn't correct it. And we are going to correct activity 4. Okay, we will use that for starting introducing electricity. And then I will explain to you science number 2. And if we've got time, science number 3. Okay? So let's go through it. I give you some time. Take it out. Press the button of likes. Hello, Marcos. What a photocopy. Science 1. Let's start with science 1. Are we ready? Okay, so what are we going to do? I'm going to read instructions for activity 4, and then you are going to write your answers there, okay, in the commentary. So please stop saying just hello and things like that. And let's start using the comments for useful things, okay? So activity 4 says, how much energy do you use every day? And can you think of 3 things you can do to help us, well, to help to save energy, okay? So who can write one of the forms we can use for saving energy there on the comments, okay? We talked about the verb save. Save means different things. For example, you can save money, okay? You can be safe when you are not in danger of dying or of illnesses, like, for example, coronavirus, okay? But you can, as I said, you can save money, you can save water, okay, when you have a shower instead of having a bed. Okay, first one, turn off the lights. Okay, so here I can write, turn off, double F, the lights. Another one. Science 1 is the first of the project, of course, that's why it's Science 1. Clase de tapas. Okay, Spanish for Hugo. Ocaña. If you play, don't haze the TV on. I don't understand that, Carmen Sanchez. If you are playing, to turn off the TV, okay, turn all of the lights, the TV, if you are not using them. What else? Come on, right. Use the air conditioner when you need it, just when you need it. Okay, so use. First one, let's summarize them. Use electronic devices just when we really. Important one for today, for English. We will talk about it later. When we really need to use them. That's, to turn off lights when you are not using them. Do not play it all the time with a tablet. Okay, that's a good thing. Don't use the dryer. Okay. But if I want to maintain my beauty, I need to use my dryer. No? To brush my hair. Turn off the engine when you are in a traffic jam. Oh, good one. Okay, if you're in a traffic jam and you cannot move, you're stuck in your car, you're in the road and you cannot move because all the cars are stopped because of an accident or whatever, to stop the engine. So you are stopping the car and you cannot continue. Perfect, good one, Celia. Well, Familia Villarroble. Oh, okay, don't use the dryer. Okay, what else? Oh, someone's calling me by the phone. Let's see if that's one of you. I don't think so, because I don't have the number. Let's see. Reading a book. Okay, reading a book. If you read a book, then you don't use a tablet, so they are connected. Okay, so let's start with it. Let's start with a photocopy with the theory that appears there. Okay, electricity. Okay, with the bottom of the photocopy. I'm going to read it for you. It's going to get a bit boring when I read, but I think that's the thing we have to do. Not use the phone always. Okay, perfect. Don't use the elevator. If you live in a second, third, fourth floor, maybe it's better to use the stairs and go upstairs and not to use the elevator. That's perfect. Okay, let's make this bigger and let's read. Let's see if we can see it properly. I think so. Okay, so let's read it. I'm going to do something. I'm going to put the blinds down so that we can see that better. Better now? Well, we are at the end of the photocopy, okay? So here we go. Electricity begins with the smallest particle in matter called atom. What is an atom? Okay, an atom is made up of protons and neutrons. Okay, here we got the image. We will explain it later. That are inside a nucleus. And electrons that are moving around outside the nucleus. Okay, so we've got the atoms. I think you know what an atom is. No, it's the smallest particle of matter. That means we are made of atoms. Games are different. Video games are made of atoms. Yes, it is. Chairs are made of atoms. My projector is made of atoms. Everything is made of atoms. Use sunlight after electricity. Okay. Stop giving answers for activity 4, please. We are here. Okay. So everything is made up of atoms. Can we see atoms just walking around? Can we see them? No, of course not. They are the smallest, okay? Smallest particles in matter. So how can we see them? Maybe we can with a microscope, okay? Yep. So, but what happens? This is an atom, okay? And here we've got a nucleus. Okay? Yes. Inside the nucleus, we've got protons and neutrons. Protons have positive charge, okay? Positive, like Deportivo, okay? But surrounding the atoms, okay, we've got electrons, okay, that are negatively charged, okay? Positive charge. Oh, great. Positive charge. Electrons, negative charge. So, these are protons. These are electrons. But what happens? There are also, okay, Betis, Hugo, Depor, Real Madrid, Barcelona. Okay? Yeah? So the Deportivo is not positive. Okay. So, yeah. So, but we've got also neutrons. They are neutral, no charge, neutral. Okay? No charge. No charge. Not positive nor negative, okay, they are neutrons. What happened? Inside a nucleus, now we've got it here. This is the nucleus. We've got protons and neutrons, okay? They are inside a nucleus. And surrounding it, as it says here, moving around. And the thing is that they are moving around, okay? They are not as stuck as protons and neutrons. There are electrons. Electrons are moving. Delta positive, therefore negative. Okay. Electric positive. Yeah, I know. Come on. Okay. So we've got protons and neutrons. But what happened? Do you think most of the objects we see on Earth are got more protons or more electrons? They've got the same number of protons and electrons. What do you think? Well, most of them got the same number of protons and electrons. That means I'm going to
got a bit
higher. Okay. That means they have no charge. That's what it says here. So protons have a positive electric charge and electrons have a negative electric charge. Neutrons have no charge. Okay. If an object has the same number of protons and electrons, it is electrically neutral. Really important information. Okay. Same number of protons and electrons. And we've got here an image. Imagine. This is my atom. Okay, this is an atom and it has. I'm not going to draw the nucleus because I don't have space there. Okay, I don't know, teacher, the same number. First option. Okay, Jose Antonio, instead of just laughing, if you can type something interesting, if you can write there something interesting, that will be great. Okay, so imagine we've got here two protons and two electrons. Is this object electrically neutral? Yes or no? Yes or no? I'm waiting for your answers. Yes. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Okay, yes, it is electrically neutral. Let's read it again. Electrically neutral. The same number of protons and electrons. Two protons, two electrons. Same number? Yes. Two protons and two electrons. So, okay. But what happens if this object loses one electron? Is it now electrically neutral? Yes or no? Now it has two protons and one electron. Is it electrically neutral now or not? No, of course not. No, it has a different number. So let's continue reading. Sometimes electrons move easily from one object to another, and this makes the object electrically charged. So what is an electrically charge? An object that doesn't have the same number of protons and or electrons. Okay? So, protons and electrons, the same. This object is neutral. Is electrically neutral. But what happens if the number of protons is not the same as the number of electrons? It is electrically charged. Okay, it's charged. Charged. No? Okay, la materia, okay, matter, está formada de átomos, de acuerdo, que componen todos los elementos de la materia. Cuando nosotros estamos compuestos de átomos, de acuerdo, y nosotros, todos nuestros órganos, todos los tejidos de nuestro cuerpo están formados de átomos. Cuando esos átomos son neutros, de acuerdo, they are neutral, porque tienen tanto el mismo número de protones que de electrones. The same number of protons and electrons. Pero ¿qué pasa? Que hay objetos, de acuerdo, como estos electrones. ¿Están en el núcleo? No. Están rodeando el núcleo. Por lo tanto, son los que se pierden o se ganan. Sin embargo, el número de protones y de neutrones, como están en el núcleo, no se pierden. ¿De acuerdo? Y eso hace que un objeto tenga, de repente gane electrones de otro átomo, un átomo gane electrones de otro átomo, o pierda. Y eso hace que esté cargado, que esté eléctricamente cargado. ¿Okay? Esto es muy importante, por eso lo explicamos en español también. Tenemos que quedarnos con este concepto. Neutro, mismo número de protones y de electrones, ¿de acuerdo? Esto es algo abstracto porque, claro, no lo vemos. Y cuando algo no lo vemos, tenemos que imaginar, tenemos que intentar analizarlo. Vamos a pensar en algún objeto que pueda estar cargado, es decir, que tenga distinto número de protones o de electrones. Pues mirad, si un objeto tiene distinto número de electrones o de protones, lo que va a hacer, se va a agobiar y no va a estar a gusto. Entonces lo que va a hacer es buscar otro objeto con el que pegarse para que uno le dé al otro esos electrones y entonces estén los dos neutros. Okay? So if they are electrically charged, one object wants to find another one so that they share electrons and they've got the same number of electrons, so they are neutral. Can you think of any object? Vamos a pensar en algún objeto que sea... Imán. Someone said imán. I don't know who you are. Okay, magnets. That's what happens with magnets. I've got magnets here. Okay, magnets. Okay, they are charged. They've got a charge. They've got an electric charge. Okay, so they need to find, they want to find other objects, other atoms to join them and to share electrons so that they get neutral. Okay, that's what happened, for example, with balloons. Okay, imagine I've got a balloon. I've got balloons, but I forgot them at class. Okay, we were going to use them last Thursday. Okay, and this is not an imán, this is a magnet. Okay, so magnets are electrically charged. Balloons, at the beginning, they are electrically neutral. But when we wrap them, for example, with our t-shirt, okay, they lose or they gain electrons, okay, and it happens the same to our t-shirt, okay? Electrons move. Why electrons? Because they are not in the nucleus, okay? So they move. And what happened? Then, if we put the balloon in our hair, as the balloon is electrically charged, it wants to look for another object where it can share or it can get the electrons. Okay? So what happened? They are looking for that. They've got a charge. Tienen una carga, igual que los magnets, que los imanes. So that's what happened. Okay, with balloons. Por eso los globos luego atraen nuestro pelo, porque quieren equilibrar ese número de electrones y de protones para estar neutros. Electrically neutral, not electrically charged. Okay, more or less. Here we've got an image too. Yep. I'm going to erase it. Where we can see what I've explained to you a little bit. Okay? We've got an object. No means number of. Okay? This means number. Okay? Number. Beautiful handwriting. Okay, so they have the same number of protons and electrons. What happens if they got the same? They are electrically neutral. Okay, same number of protons and electrons, electrically neutral. Okay, what happens if we wrap them as a balloon? Frotar, wrap. Electrons move. And this one gains extra electrons, and this one loses electrons. So what happened? This one is negatively charged. Como tiene más electrones, está cargado negativamente. ¿Sí? Negativamente. Y este, como ha perdido los electrones, porque al frotarse, los electrones que no están en el núcleo del átomo, sino que están por fuera, se mueven con mayor facilidad, lo que han hecho... han saltado al objeto, ¿ok? So electrons are transferred, and now this object is negatively charged, and this object is positively charged. If one object is negatively charged and the other one is positively charged, they want to get together. Okay. So to become again, or to stay again, electrically neutral. Okay. Bien, importante, antes de seguir, como veo que solo estamos saludando y haciendo tonterías por los comentarios, lo que vamos a hacer es limitar los comentarios. Si queréis, quito los comentarios. Lo que no quiero es que estéis saludando todo el rato, porque al final lo único que estáis pendientes es de escribir comentarios y no de lo que yo explico. Entonces, si os parece, os mando las fotocopias y seguís aprendiendo vosotros por vuestra cuenta. De vosotros depende. Yo tengo el colchón de mi habitación de pie ahora mismo, la ropa de la cama metida en el armario, todas las estanterías puestas, montadas esto, y vosotros seguís haciendo el tonto. Entonces, de vosotros depende, ¿vale? ¿Sí? No hace falta que me saludéis todo el rato. ¿De acuerdo? Tampoco hace falta que preguntéis a la gente que quién eres. Entonces, como no puedo estar aquí, ahí, poner esto, subir la persiana, pues o me lo ponéis más fácil o directamente lo cerramos. A mí me da igual, ¿eh? Ok, so let's continue. So, taking into account this, look, this is what we've talked about. Magnets. Okay? Magnets got, as you said before, magnets. I've got magnets here. Okay? This is a magnet. You can't see it very well, but this is a magnet. Well, this is a magnet too. Okay? So, one question, and now you have to write. Is this magnet electrically neutral or electrically charged? Electrically neutral or electrically charged? What do you think? Right. Time for writing. Time for typing. You type on a computer. You don't write. You type. Okay? Who type with Y or with I? I'm letting down. With I. I don't want to. Neutral. So magnets are electrically neutral or charged? What do you think? They are charged. They are not neutral. They are electrically charged. Let's go back to science one. Vamos a science 1 otra vez. Hemos dicho, un objeto que está neutro, ¿de acuerdo? No busca pegarse con otro. Pero si está cargado, es decir, tiene o más protones o más electrones, ¿de acuerdo? Lo que va a buscar es juntarse con otro para compartir electrones. Por lo tanto, está cargado, tiene una carga, ¿no? Es positivo o negativo. Y eso lo vemos en los imanes. Mirad. Ok. ¿No? Magnets got the positive and the negative poles. Ok. We've talked about north and south. We will talk about it later. Okay, so magnets are charged, but not charged. No. Charged. Okay? Charged. Okay? So remember, electrons and protons, the same number, this is neutral. But if we don't have the same number of electrons and protons, this is charged. Okay? It's an adjective. Yeah. Okay. This is charged. So magnets are charged. Okay. Let's see how many battery do I have. Okay. Enough. So magnets are charged. The whiteboard is charged. The cork is not charged. But the board is charged, okay? The cork is neutral, because if I place the magnet here, oh, it falls down. Okay. Yep. Positive or negative? That's it. Very good. You got my only one that I would charge. Okay, Marcos, doesn't matter. Understand. Okay. So now, let's continue. Let's continue. Let's read this text. Can you see it clearly? How did they arrive there? Okay, let's go to it. I'm going to make it bigger. So that we can read it clearly. Okay. How do you think Columbus and his fleet? A fleet is a group of ships or boats, okay? These were ships. Could travel through the Atlantic Ocean. How? Did he need something to orientate himself? Of course, we've talked about it before, no? We've talked about it in the introduction of the project. David, if you don't have this photocopy, Nacho Bermejo, these photocopies are on Google Drive, okay? Todas estas fotocopias están en Google Drive. Todas. Vamos a meternos. Mirad. Asunciónvallecas.es. Entramos ahí. Área educativa, infantil y primaria. Blogs y enlaces. O bueno, o como lo hacéis mucho, ¿vale? Y aquí está bien. Pero como lo hacéis mucho, vamos para abajo. Si entráis en la página del cole y vais para abajo. Blogs, educación infantil y primaria. Y aquí tenemos los enlaces de quinto. En los enlaces de quinto, como he explicado al principio, tenemos, que no sé muy bien, ahora está lo primero, porque claro, es lo más importante, David Tareas, coronavirus, ¿de acuerdo? Si nos metemos ahí, tenemos inglés y science. Pues esto está en science, estamos dando science ahora, luego daremos un poquito de inglés. ¿Vale? With a compass, muy bien, no sé si estáis respondiendo ahí. Vale, I have this for a copy, perfecto. Y aquí tenemos Science 1, Science 2, 3, 4, okay, and 5, okay? Tomorrow, we will do this one together, okay? We will do activity 2 together. But let's just start doing activity 1, okay? Instead of starting with Science 2, let's just start with activity 1. I would like you to do it for Friday so we can start doing it now, right now. Okay? So let's see. I'm going to make it bigger. Okay. Here we are. Let's see. Complete the labels. Okay, the labels are these lines that tell us the part of an atom. Okay? Don't have computerized in a phone. And TV. Okay, Ethan, that's not a problem. That's perfect. What is this photocopy? Okay, this is Science 4. Sorry, I'm going too fast. Perdón, estoy yendo demasiado rápido. Venga, os doy un poco de tiempo. Science 4. Si no la tenéis impresa, abridla ahí y escuchadme solo. Y vais. O directamente abrirlo aquí, no hace falta ni que la busquéis. Vamos a ir viendo a ver si podemos hacer esto y luego cuando ya lo hagáis, tranquilamente lo vais haciendo. ¿Vale? Sí, de momento lo vamos viendo aquí, lo vamos haciendo todos en conjunto y luego lo escribís. De esa forma lo vemos ahora, lo entendemos y luego en casa incluso podéis dibujarlo tranquilamente, es para el viernes. Y lo vamos a subir al modo, luego os enseño cómo, ¿vale? Venga. Okay, so complete the labels using words from the box. Here we've got the words of the box. Proton. What is a proton? Proton is the positive charge of an atom. Okay. What is neutral? Neutral means no charge. Positive. Okay. Which part of the atom is positive? I've said it. Neutron, negative, electron, nucleus, and particles. Okay. So here we are. This is the nucleus. It's said here. Okay. So let's start with it. Atoms are the smallest in matter. Are the smallest proton, neutral, positive, neutral? Which word do you think I have to write here? Protons are the smallest. Type. What do you think I have to write here?
Oh, Patricia, always Patricia. Very good.
Perfect, Patrick. Particles in matter. Yeah, they are the smallest particles in matter. If you go to science one, it's said there. Yeah. Particles in matter. Okay, and now we are going to see the different parts of an atom. Okay, particles, very good. Okay, let's see, one moment. Okay, this is the nucleus, and the nucleus is formed of, what is the nucleus formed of? What two elements of the atom? Electrons, neutrons, or protons? What two elements?
The nucleus is formed of
what? Protons and
neutrons.
No? Look. Nucleus. The nucleus is formed of protons and neutrons. Protons and neutrons. This is the nucleus. Okay? So protons and neutrons. Not newtons. Neutrons, okay? Neutrones, okay? Jimmy Neutron, okay? Let's continue. Here we are. Okay, so the nucleus is formed of protons and neutrons. So now, this is the nucleus. So we can say that the red ones are the protons, for example. Doesn't matter, okay? You can write protons here. And this one, neutrons. Doesn't matter. No? That's what you said. The nucleus is formed of protons and neutrons. Doesn't matter if you write here protons and they're neutrons. Doesn't matter. Okay. So now, type. What is the charge of protons? Okay, one moment. We have used the proton, we have used the neutrons, we have used particles. Now, let's see, neutral, positive, negative, electron, or nucleus. So protons, the charge is neutral, positive, or negative. Type, protons. Positive. Yeah, positive. It's positive, yes, very good. Yeah, so protons are positive. And neutrons? Are they neutral, negative, electron, or nucleus? Any electron. Ah, well, a nucleus is here. It's already crossed. Chloe, esa fotocopia no pasa nada. Tú puedes dibujar esto. Tú puedes dibujar esto y luego poner en el 2. 2, A, tal, B, tal. Neutrons are neutral or negative? What do you think? Neutrons, neutral or negative? Neutrons, neutral or negative? Neutrons, neutrals or negative? Neutrons, no charge. Oh, Marcos. Negative? No. Neutrons are neutral. Los neutrones son neutros. No charge. No son ni positivos ni negativos. They are electrically neutral. Neutral. So neutrons are neutral. Ok. Protones positivos. Neutrones neutros. Son los que están en el núcleo. Pero claro, es que nos falta un elemento del núcleo. Falta el elemento negativo. Al tener el mismo número de elementos positivos y negativos, se equilibra. No nos importa el número de neutrones, porque no van a cambiar la carga del átomo. Porque son neutrones, no tienen carga, como ha dicho Marcos. Really good, Marcos. Ok, class, your point for Marcos. Oh, I'm going to read it here. Marcos, Mr. Frames. Frames, 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 frames. Frames, frames, frames. And now, last one. What are the element of, what is the element of an atom which is surrounding it, which is not in the nucleus, is surrounding it? Is that the proton? Is that a, sorry, and it was. What are these? Very good. YouTube sign. I don't know who you are. YouTube sign, who you are. Are you Ethan? Okay, Orion, I didn't see you. Sorry. Electron. Yeah, this is an electron. This is an electron. Okay, there electrons flow. Okay. YouTube sign, Hugo T. Okay, all the worst. Okay. So yes, if they are electrons, what is their charge? What is their charge? Positive? Neutral? Negative? Oh, not bad. Negative. Perfect. Perfect. Very good. Very good, Oriana. Very good, Hugo. Okay. So this activity is from Science 1. Okay? This is the first part of Science 1. And Activity 2 is the second part of Science 1. And I think that's too much for today. We are going to do a break, okay? Before we finish, do you have any questions? Do you have any doubts about Science 1? Antes de acabar, vamos a acabar. Hoy ya hemos acabado con Science 1. Creo que quería ir demasiado rápido. Vamos poco a poco. Muy bien. Nora, nos saludamos, porfa. Ya solo contestamos a través de eso. Really good. So today, yes, Science 1. Tomorrow we will start with Science 2. Do you have any questions, any doubts? ¿Tenemos alguna pregunta, algo que no hayamos entendido? Write it down. Type it in English. Okay? Type your questions. Questions now about Science 1. If you don't have questions, we've got a break, okay? We have a break. Preguntas. Preguntas de Science 1. ¿Qué es electrically charged? ¿Qué es electrically neutral? ¿Y qué son los elementos? ¿Vale? Eso es lo que hemos visto hoy. Voy a escribirlo en inglés. Ask me if you don't understand something. Okay? So, let's just stop the projector for a second. Wow, Tres Cantos light. Natural light is amazing. It's better than Vallecas light. So as a summary of the class, okay, we've talked about what atoms are. We've also talked about the elements that made up atoms. And we talked about the difference between being electrically neutral, okay, and being electrically charged. Do you have any questions about this? Questions first, and then we talk about homework. Can you see it? I think you see it worse. Let's see. ¿Se ve mejor con la persiana levantada o bajada? ¿La pizarra se ve mejor o peor ahora que antes? No se ve, ¿verdad? Okay, well, so we are going to do a break, okay? Hacemos un descanso. No homework. You got a homework for Friday till last Friday. So that's what you have to do about science, okay? And it's 25 past. I'm going to eat a mandarina and maybe some chocolate, Andrea. And then we continue with English. Okay, we will meet in 15 minutes, okay? At 20 to 12, we meet again. Nos vemos de nuevo a menos 20. 15 minutitos de descanso, meriendo algo, tengo hambre, bebo agua. Y a menos 20 nos vemos. Para mañana pondremos aquí luz artificial para que se vea bien y no nos dé ningún reflejo cuando quitamos el proyector. ¿Vale? No hay deberes más que los que mandé el viernes pasado. See you later, alligators. Ugly and lovely students. See you. Bye, bye.